tetraacetic acid. EDTA means ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid. So estimation of total hardness of a given water sample by EDTA method. Here aim is the to estimate the total hardness present in given water sample. Estimate total hardness of given water sample, a total hardness present in given water sample by using approximately 0.01 m. M means molar EDTA. Ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid. This we are taking as a concentration 0.01 m solution. Principle. What is the principle behind this experiment? Whenever EDTA solution is added to calcium metal ion solution, because not only calcium metal, hard water, calcium or magnesium metal ion solution. Hardness is, what is hardness? Presence of calcium and magnesium salts of sulfates,
chlorides
and sulfates. That is the permanent hardness. Bicarbonates, chlorides and sulfate salts of calcium and magnesium is the total hardness. Bicarbonates hardness is the permanent hardness. Sulfates and chlorides hardness is the permanent hardness. Total hardness is temporary hardness and permanent hardness. Temporary hardness plus permanent hardness is equal to total hardness. Okay. So calcium and magnesium. Calcium and magnesium salts of bicarbonates, sulfates and chlorides. So here we are taking EDTA as a burette solution, given hard water sample as a conical flask solution. Conical flask solution. Whenever EDTA solution is added to hard water, it forms a stable complex. It forms a stable complex and displaces the indicator complex by EDTA. Actually, first here we are using areochrome black tea indicator. Areochrome black tea indicator. In this experiment, indicator is the areochrome black tea, EBT. EBT stands for areochrome black tea. First, whenever for solution, hot water sample, solution here is nothing but hot water sample. Hot water sample, we are adding 1 or 2 drops of areochrome black tea indicator and then buffer After that, we are titrating against EDTA. So whenever we are adding iriochrome black tea, so whatever the metals present in the hot water, it may be calcium or magnesium, react with iriochrome black tea indicator, it's form unstable wine red colored complex. Unstable wine red colored complex. Reaction between metal and indicator is the unstable. It forms unstable complexes. It forms unstable complexes. Here we are indicating this calcium EBT or magnesium EBT, whatever it may be, or metal EBT. Simply, metal is which may be any magnesium or calcium, whatever it may be. Magnesium or calcium. While we are titrating with EDTA, what is happening? Whatever the unstable complex, calcium EBT or magnesium EBT, metal iriochrome black tea indicator complex, react with EDTA, it forms stable deep blue color complex. Stable deep blue color complex. Indicator as well as, it will be, comes out as a indicator, as a EBT. First, we are adding hot water indicator, iriochrome black tea. It react, iriochrome black tea indicator is react to metals, metal ions present on that hot water, maybe calcium or magnesium. They form unstable wine red color complex. While we are treating these unstable complex, while we are titrating these unstable complex with EDTA, ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid, actually we are using here disodium salt of mono or disodium salts of ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid we are using. Okay. So it forms metal EDTA complex, stable deep blue color metal EDTA complex. Hence, here endpoint is the wine red blue color, changing of color from wine red to blue, deep blue. What is the endpoint in this experiment means changing of color from wine red color to blue color. EDTA metal ion complex is stable only at pH 10. Hence, we are adding buffer here. We are adding buffer for getting stable complex. We are adding, initially we are adding buffer. This is the principle. This is the principle. When next, what is the experiment? In the part A, what you are doing? You has to do. First, it has to prepare stranded solution of magnesium sulfate. For any, unknown solutions, if you has to weigh, if you has to estimate, it has to take, you require one stranded solution, one stranded experiment, one standard titration. For that, you are preparing stranded magnesium sulfate solution. From that, you are comparing the unknown water sample hardness. First, known amount of standard magnesium sulfate solution you are preparing, and then estimating that with that EDTA, titrating with that EDTA, with the comparison of that, you are determining unknown hot water sample hardness. So in the part A, what you are taking, nearly 0.25 grams of magnesium sulfate crystals in a clean and dry weighing bottle. Clean and dry weighing bottle are taking and weigh accurately up to fourth decimal of decimal place using rider in a simple balance. In the analytical balance, actually you learnt about in intermediate and regarding analytical balance. In the analytical balance, while you are coming, first we will explain regarding analytical balance, how you can weigh. Actually, weighing bottle is there. That weighing bottle, after cleaning and drying, you are taking approximately nearly 0.25 grams of magnesium sulfate. Then weighing that up to fourth decimal place using rider in a simple balance, analytical balance. Actually, after, suppose this is 0.25 grams, only we are, this is approximate. Like this here, suppose after weighing these things, 0.2500 like that it come. Not exactly, it's maybe 0.2490, 0.2499 or 0.2501 like that it will come. In the table I will explain what is the milligrams position, what is the grams position, like rider value like that. Then after weighing the magnesium sulfate, it is transferred to the magnesium sulfate into clean 100 ml stranded flask. Clean 100 ml stranded flask with the help of funnel. So after weighing that from the weighing bottle, it will transferred into the 100 ml stranded flask. After transferring completely the substance, you has to weigh the empty weighing bottle weight accurately. After that only you will get the substance weight. First weighing bottle plus substance weight, then empty weighing bottle weight. Weighing bottle plus substance weight minus empty weighing bottle weight gives rise to, it will give to magnesium sulfate weight. Magnesium sulfate weight. Okay. So after that, whatever you transferred in the magnesium sulfate into the 100 ml stranded flask, it is dissolves with minimum distilled water and then make up to the mark. Standard flask having the mark, up to that mark and the neck of standard flask, there is a mark, up to that you has to make up with water, distilled water. First it has to completely dissolve with minimum amount of distilled water. Then after that you can add the distilled water up to the 100 ml. 100 ml in the sense it will indicate with mark. And then shake well the standard flask to obtain uniform concentration and keep aside for further use. So here in the calculation part, weight of weighing bottle plus substance. So you can get grams, milligrams. Milligrams less than 100. I mean, actually in the, if you are weighing fractional box, 500 grams, 500 mg fractional weight box. In the fractional weight box, you having the measures. 1 500 mg weight, 2 200 mg weights, fractions, 1 100 mg, and then 2 50 mg 20 mg, 10 mg fractions are there in your fractional weight box. In your fractional weight box, along with that rider also there. So for you, easy way of understanding here, whatever grams is there here, you are noting down here, 2 grams or 3 grams or whatever it may be, noting down here, because weighing bottle weight also comes to here. Okay, then mg, milligrams, greater than 100 mg, I mean 500, whatever it may be, this noting down here, and then less than 100 mg noting here. Then after that, second position is the 500 mg, 200 mg, like that is there, na? That will be, you has to take it as a after point first decimal. After point, yeah.
Excuse me.
Tell me. Yes, yes, tell me.
Ma'am, my dad for 2 minutes, ma'am.
Emma?
Daddy call chestunnaru, ma'am, for 2 minutes, ma'am.
Why are you asking me during the class?
అంటే కాల్ లిఫ్ట్ చేస్తే ఎగ్జిట్ అవుతాం.
సో నియర్లీ హియర్ ఫస్ట్ యూ కెన్ ఇన్ దిస్ హియర్ మీన్ వాట్ ఎవర్ గ్రామ్స్ యు ఆర్ టేకింగ్ దట్ ఈస్ ద దిస్ పాయింట్ ఆర్ 2 grams 3 grams లైక్ దట్ వాట్ ఎవర్ 500 mg, 200 mg, 100 mg is there, na? That is this point. After decimal, I mean after point, first decimal. Then less than less than 100 means 50 mg, 20 mg. You has to add here as a after point second decimal. Rider position, main rider position should be at third, as a third decimal, like here, this 0.001. Sub rider sub position is 0.0000. So here, this is the grams position, this is the mean milligrams position, this is the milligrams with less than 100 position, this is the rider main position. While we are calculating, this is the sub position of your rider. With that, up to fourth decimal you has to weigh the substance. Same thing you has to weigh empty weighing bottle also. Empty weighing bottle. Suppose if we are getting 3 grams here, then here 600 mg, and then less than that 50 mg, and then main position may be 3 or 2, sub position may be 2. Your value is weight of that weighing bottle and substance value is 3.653. Subdivision you has to multiply with 5. Subdivision has to multiply. Sorry, multiply with 2. Sorry, with 2. Here you are getting subdivision 2, right? Here value is 4. Value is 4. Understand? Now you weigh the substance, and then weighing bottle weight is the 3.6534 grams. See, 3.6534 grams. So like that, empty weighing bottle weight 100 60 mg and main position may be 2, sub position may be 1. So what is here? How much is the here? 3.1622, because sub position of the rider should be multiplied with 2. 3.1622 grams. So while we are, so weight of weighing bottle plus substance weight is W1, we are taking as a W1, that is 3.6534. Weight of empty weighing bottle we are taking as a W2. So what is the minus value of here? W1 minus W2 is equal to how much?
Four nine one two.
So 0.4912. This is the substance weight. Just then, I explained to you how you have to calculate these things. Okay, understand? Like this, you have to calculate substance and then W1. W1 indicates weighing bottle plus substance weight. Then W2 indicates empty weighing bottle weight. While you are minus W1 minus W2 is equal to weight of magnesium sulfate substance. That is the W. That is the W. In the grams. How you can calculate molarity of magnesium sulfate solution? M1 is equal to weight of magnesium sulfate. That is, you are getting here magnesium sulfate, weight of magnesium sulfate by gram molecular weight of magnesium sulfate. Gram molecular weight of magnesium sulfate. Then, actually, what is the molarity? Molarity is the what is the equation for molarity? Amount of gram molecular weight, amount of substance present in 1000 or 1 liter of
1000 ml
solution. While we are taking here 10, because we are taking 100 ml stranded flask here, 100 ml stranded flask here, 100 ml standard flask. That's why we are calculating for 100 only. Calculating for 100 only. So weight of magnesium sulfate by gram molecular weight of magnesium sulfate into how much? Suppose 100 by 1000 is the last. Sorry, 1000 by 100 and 10? 10, right? Actually, we have to calculate as per definition of molarity, we are taking in 1000 ml. But we are calculating for 100 ml only. We are transferring here 100 ml stranded flask. 100 ml stranded flask. We are taking in the 100 ml stranded flask only. Hence, here we are multiplying with 10. Weight of magnesium sulfate by gram molecular weight of magnesium sulfate into 10. That is the molarity of magnesium sulfate solution. Molarity should be indicated with with capital M. Units of molarity is molars, capital M. Units for weight is grams. It should be indicated with small g. not capital, small g. That is the first part of the experiment, part A. In the second part, standardization of EDTA solution. So whatever here you prepared your standard solution of standard magnesium sulfate solution in the part A. Part B, standardization of EDTA solution. Whatever you prepared the solution, with that you can titrate that magnesium sulfate is titrated with standard EDTA. Standard EDTA. The burette is cleaned and rinsed with tap water after the distilled water, and then EDTA. Finally, first you has to clean tap water, and then you has to rinse with distilled water, and finally with EDTA solution, with less small amount of EDTA solution. After that, the burette is filled with EDTA solution and note down the initial reading. Initial reading in the sense, sometimes you are running, that time you can take that thing also. Suppose 10.5 ml you used, after that you can continue the same burette readings 10.5 onwards. Hence initial reading you are noting. Then ml of the standard solution is prepared out into a clean colical flask. So already in the first part you prepared 100 ml of magnesium sulfate solution, standard magnesium sulfate solution. From that you has to pipette out 20 ml of that solution, 20 ml of that standard solution. Is pipette out into a clean conical flask and add 20 ml of distilled water. Because why we are adding for 20 ml, sometimes it's maybe little accuracy like that, we are adding some amount of distilled water. 5 ml of ammonical buffer, 5 ml of ammonical buffer. Buffer, we has to maintain pH 10. To maintaining pH 10, we are adding buffer, ammonical buffer. And 2 to 3 drops of areochrome black tea indicator. Areochrome black tea indicator. The solution turns to wine red color. Whenever we are adding areochrome black tea indicator, at that time solution turns to wine red color. Whatever conical flask what we are taking, 20 ml of hot water, 20 ml of standard magnesium sulfate solution, 20 ml of distilled water, 5 ml of ammonical buffer, and then 2 to 3 drops of areochrome black tea indicator. That entire solution is with violet color. That solution, that mixture of solution is titrating against EDTA solution, which is taken in the burette. So titration continues till the color changes from violet to blue color. That is the end point, till the color changes from violet to blue color. And then you has to note down the volume of EDTA run down from the burette. Suppose initial value 0.1 ml or 0.2 ml or 0.0, whatever it may be. Final value may be 20.5 or 20.6, whatever it may be. You has to repeat the titration till two concurrent values are coinciding. Suppose here volume of EDTA, initial value, final value minus initial value is the volume of EDTA rundown. Suppose initial value is 0.0, final value is 20.56, volume of EDTA rundown is 20.5. Suppose 0.1 ml initial value. Final value may be 25.6. What is the volume of EDTA rundown? 25.5 ml. So like this, you has to titrate, you has to repeat the same experiment, two concordant values you are getting. I mean 25.5, 20.5. Concurrent means continuously. First time 20.5 or second time 20.5, 5.6, third time 25.5 means it's not concurrent. If 1 and 2 values are not concurrent, next you have to proceed with third one. Okay. So note down the tabular column based on the titer value, strength of EDTA is calculated. Here pipette solution is the magnesium, standard magnesium sulfate solution. Burette solution is the standard EDTA solution. Volume V1 is equal to how much magnesium sulfate you are pipetted out? 20 ml. Then volume V2 is equal to, molarity M1. Molarity you already calculated in the part A. Here you calculated molarity of magnesium sulfate solution. This value you has to be taken here. And then number of moles of magnesium sulfate is equal to 1 molar. Then here taking burette solution is the EDTA solution. How much amount of EDTA we run, what is the rundown? Here we are taking that V2 as a V2. Then molarity M2 has to find out now. N1 number of moles N2 is equal to 1. Hence M1 V1 is equal to N1. Because N1 is equal to N2, that's why M1 V1 is equal to M2 V2. With this, we can find out molarity of EDTA solution, that is we are naming as M2. M1 is the molarity of standard magnesium sulfate solution. M2 is the molarity of EDTA solution. Here we are standardized. Next in the part C, what we are doing? Estimation of total hardness of given water sample. For a unknown water sample, we are getting, right? We are given. We have to estimate. Same thing. Pipette out. I mean, depends on the concentration of that. We are taking, sometimes we are taking 40 ml, sometimes we are taking 50 ml like that. Pipette out 40 ml of hot water of a given water sample into a clean conical flask and 20 ml of 20 ml of distilled water and 5 ml of ammonical buffer solution to maintain pH 10, then 2 to 3 drops of ureochrome black tea indicator. 2 to 3 drops of ureochrome black tea indicator. And titrate the mixtures of these solution against EDTA taken in a burette like pot B. The end point is winded to deep blue color. Repeat the solution. Repeat the titration for two concurrent values and then values, note down the values in the tabular column and then calculate M4, molarity of hard water solution, molarity of hard water. Here pipette solution is the hard water, burette solution is the EDTA. volume V3 is here we are pipetting 40 ml of hot water. Volume V3 is 40 ml. Molarity M3 is equal to, we have to find out hot water molarity. We have to find out number of moles is 1. Hence then burette solution is the EDTA. Volume is here V4. Molarity for same numerical, that's why we are mentioning here molarity M4. Actually whatever we are getting the molarity as a M2, we are taking as a value, considering the value here in the part B. Molarity of EDTA solution we standardize, that one we are taking here as a molarity value. But why we are mentioning here M4 in the sense, because V4, M4, N4, like that we are mentioning here M4. Okay. So M3 V3 by M3 is equal to M3 M4 V4 by M4. With this equation we are getting mean molarity of hot water. M3 is equal to M4 V4 by N4 into N2 by V3. That is the molarity of unknown hard water sample. Unknown hard water sample. So total hardness of given water sample is equal to M3, that is the molarity of hard water sample, into calcium carbonate molecular weight or magnesium carbonate molecular weight into 100 is equal to, I mean how much we are getting is the ppm r ppm r mg per liter r mg per liter. Then from this, suppose this is the total hardness. Total hardness of the hot. So here molarity of magnesium sulfate solution we find out. Molarity of EDTA solution we find out. Molarity of hot water we find out. Total hardness of water sample also we find out. Then after that, what we has to do? Suppose if we require temporary hardness or permanent hardness, what we has to do? Now we calculated total hardness. If we require temporary hardness or permanent hardness, same water sample, we has to take same water sample maybe 500 ml or whatever it may be, then completely thoroughly boiled. After boiling and cooling, we has to take 50 ml of the boiled water sample. Then we has to estimate molarity of that water. With that, what we will get? Permanent hardness we will get, because temporary hardness will be removed by heating. We know total hardness and then we know temporary permanent hardness. So total hardness minus permanent hardness is equal to temporary hardness. So this is the estimation of hardness of water by EDTA, complexometric titration. Why we are telling this experiment as a complexometric titration means complexometric titration is the means, because here whatever the hardness giving metal ions are present in that water, either calcium or magnesium, it forms as a complex with EDTA. Hence, this experiment is known as complexometric titration or estimation of hardness by EDTA method.